from Center City, this is Good Day Philadelphia.
And parents, aunts and uncles, grandparents, Jen has a story you need to hear today.
Yeah, here's the deal. We all hear about warnings, dangerous toys, dangerous products. We hear about this Consumer Product Safety Commission, the CPSC, and that there is this big website. But no one really knows what the toys are. Well, we did something. We sent high-powered, big-shot attorney Tom Klein on a shopping trip.
Okay.
He found many of the top 10 most dangerous toys. He didn't find them in a little tiny store. He found them on store shelves that you are going to be going to this holiday season. So if your children have asked for these toys, and I can tell you these are regular toys, name brand toys, Dora the Explorer type stuff. These are the toys that you need to know about. We're not talking about insignificant things, strangulation. We're talking about death. These are toys you need to know about. From an electric shock to a toy that could create a serious eye injury. There are some toys that one government watch group wants to warn you about, specific things within toys. Problem is, you probably haven't gotten the message until now. Tom Klein is here, and you have sued many companies for many defective products, but around this season, you're very worried about toys like this.
We're here today, Jen, to talk about dangers and try to avoid injuries so that there are not companies that are sued and so that parents don't have injured children.
So just real briefly, the CPSC gives a couple of different things that they say are dangerous, and then it's up to these parents who are flipping out because of prices and kids and all the other stuff to try to decipher what the things are and in which toys they may be found.
That's right, and some of these toys actually have warnings, small print that says, you know, this is a danger, that's a danger, but the CPSC has a number of categories: small parts, small magnets, batteries, projectiles, things that can obviously hurt you and your children, obviously, and in this particular, and your pets, I might add.
Yeah.
And in this category, we have a number of toys that fit these categories and are clear and obvious dangers.
Okay, so we're going to begin with this sword. And the thing that you don't like about this sword is that there's a warning on it, but the warning is pretty crazy.
Jan, for four-year-olds and up, do not hit any object. Do not hit any person. Now it has a little sound to it, too.
Yeah, and the sound will basically, like, what else is a kid going to do with a sword other than try to hit something?
That's right, and feel it.
Yeah, it's heavy.
It's heavy, it's hard, and it's a danger. Would you want your four-year-old, this is for a four-year-old, to be up there, and then to add, this is a ninja toy, this is your ninja toy, so you get to throw things, and it says, well, do not hit anyone's eye.
Yeah, but you're throwing it.
It falls into the common sense category.
Okay.
This may have a warning on it, but common sense tells you, and I don't know why we don't have our thing,
because
it's live TV. But it has sound to it as well. So that's one.
Okay. Now this right here, it says this is not a toy, but it looks like a toy. It lights up like a toy. Why is it not a toy?
Well, first of all, we bought it in the toy department.
Okay.
And it says on it, it's not a toy. We went to Walmart. This is, suggestion to Walmart.
Right.
It should not be in the toy department.
Okay.
And it's an electrical shock hazard. You look in the back, look at what your little child can do. Put your finger right into here.
And the
warning tells you, yeah, go ahead.
It says unplug when you're not using. What person, what parent knows to unplug a lamp every time they're not using it?
Well, you have these instructions, use care and instructions, and then item F is unplug the product when leaving the home. In small type, it says, when retiring for the night or leave unattended. They tell you that it's not a toy, it's a lamp. Then they tell you it's not a lamp that you can leave plugged in.
Crazy.
Make any sense?
Not to me.
This is and it's a Nickelodeon character.
Yeah.
And does it tell your child? How old of a child would be? Three or 4 year old would love that, play with it like a doll, and most important danger.
They got their hands all over it.
They got their hands right into the bulb.
Okay. The last thing
with
you
their
have
wet hands, sure.
Is a very popular toy. It's this Havoc Heli. And the thing about it, it looks safe enough, but there's a real serious explosion hazard here.
Well, if you go to YouTube and go to lithium batteries, you'll find a number of sites, but one in particular which shows these being tested. And you have a helicopter here that is meant to fly remotely. It has the lithium battery inside. It's being banged around. And then we all know there are something like a million lithium batteries that have been recalled over the years. And these lithium batteries are the danger. Not the nice little helicopter that's going to go buzzing around for your little tyke. It's the battery when the child goes to recharge it. Then you're told, well, only adults are going to recharge it.
No
well,
way.
You know that the child's going to recharge it.
And they're going to slam it into a wall.
And it comes in a bigger version. You have the bigger plane.
Oh, nice.
Same thing. And this also contains the battery, which is sensitive to being broken. And the plane goes flying along. And we have another danger. These fit in the category that the CPSC tells us about. There are also websites. There are also compilations of lists. There's a very famous lawyer, Don Keenan, who has Keenan's Kids. These all fit on the 10 worst toys list. There's a watchdog group called Watch.
Yeah.
It's also on their 10. These are within their 10 worst toys list.
You are not done. You did a very thorough shopping list. So
did Santa do okay?
Santa did okay. You're going to come back
bear
at 8:15.
Greetings.
Yeah, except for the fact that now we can't give these toys to any kids because they're bad toys.
Well, you can still buy them. They have the appropriate warnings. They've met all of the standards.
All right.
But they are clearly in the category of judge for yourself.
Okay.
We're here so that kids don't get hurt.
Thank you very much. We'll see you in the next hour.
See you in the next hour.
Okay. Guys, back over to you.
Good information. Thank you.